Good morning, everyone. We are here for another episode with Get Fit with Lisa Pasullo. I hope everyone is having a fabulous week and is looking forward to Easter weekend. I'm going to actually do things a little bit differently today. We're still going to go through our warm-up. We're going to go through part of our workout. But I'm going to actually talk about a couple things that I see happen a lot of times in the gym. So we're going to go over what not to do so that you don't get hurt or that you're not improperly working your body. Start with our warm-up. Keep in mind we're doing an abbreviated portion of it. Normal workout, you want to have a really good dynamic warm-up for like 10 to 12 minutes. We're probably going to do maybe 2 to 3 minutes here, maybe a little bit more, maybe a little bit less. Make sure you have your water. Make sure you've checked with your physician before you start any type of workout program whatsoever. And also, anytime you do any of my workouts, try to get some food in you about an hour prior to it. You want to have food. You got to have food to make sure your workouts are efficient and that you have the energy to do them. So we're going to start very simple warm-up. All we're going to do is we're just going to lift right up, keeping it basic. Keep in mind that if you have back injuries or knee injuries, you want to be very careful when you're pulling up. Go at your own pace. The show airs, you can tape it, you can write things down, and then you can practice your form. So we're just gonna do four more. Last two here. Awesome. Now, we're gonna go into a squat. We all know I love squats if you've been watching me. I'm gonna come a little bit more than hip width. Hip width is technically two fists. That's a really good guide that you can use. I'm gonna keep my toes nice and straight, and I'm gonna sink down. I'm gonna slightly arch my back, and I'm gonna tuck my chin. Hands can go wherever you want them to go. People prefer hands, whatever you wanna do, as long as you're comfortable. I always tend to go in the front. Making sure that when you come down, you want to really work to getting to your 90 degree, so you're in a line, and your knees, this is what we don't want to do. Okay, watch, ready? When we do this, you don't want to come down here and lift your heel up. I see that all of the time in the gym. Want to warm up really, really well. So we're going to come down for 8 more, squeezing the glutes up, pushing through the heels. There's 90 million different ways that you can work out, but this is really easy just to demonstrate. We'll just do 4 more. Last 2. Last 1. Good. Now we're going to go into a lunge. We're going to keep a very stationary lunge. Left foot's going to come to the front. Right leg's going to come back. I'm going to bend down. Now I'm going to show you this from the side also. So when I come down, watch this knee. Right here, I'm not pivoting forward, I'm staying here, my back staying up nice and strong, squeezing my glutes. I'm gonna press up through my heel. That is a perfect way to do a lunge. Again, if you have some knee issues, watch your depth, be careful. We only get one body, okay? Let's treat it good. Let's get 5 more on this side. Pushing through my heel, 3, 2, and 1, coming on up. We're going to switch into the other side. Same thing. Position your body. Take the time to do it. You don't need to rush through this. Dig right into the back, coming down, squeezing up. I'm driving all my weights on my front heel. Good. We're going to do 5 more. 4, 3, pushing, 2, and 1, come on up. Now, I'm gonna come a little bit wider. I'm gonna come into a slight squat, and then I'm gonna come down into a half squat, okay? Still just warming up. Notice my toes are out now, so all of my weight is on the outer portions of my feet, but don't roll your ankles. Then half, top of the squat. Super easy, squat, half. Just hitting different muscles. Warming everything up. Now you'll notice too, when I come down, my knees push out. You don't want to try to have, you don't want them to cave in. Here, we'll just do 4 more of these. Keeping the glutes nice and tight the whole time. And we'll do 1 more just to make it really good. Right here, good. Now again, that was a very, very quick warm-up. So if you're at home, you could do jumping rope, you could do some jumping jacks, you could do fast feet, you could do push-ups, so many different ways you can do. Again, knee up, knee out. Fabulous way for get a dynamic warm-up. Here's another great one, Frankenstein's. Super easy. You don't even need a lot of space, a little bit of space. So we are going to work with a band today. These are amazing. These are called Rogue Bands. You can get them at Amazon, Target, everywhere. They're all different strengths, and the company will tell you what it is. Now, we're going to do what's called the good morning exercise. This is a fabulous exercise working your posterior chain, meaning your back of your body, okay? I always see this one done wrong, so I'm going to teach you how to do this properly today. With a band versus a bar, I feel like a band is a lot safer and it targets your muscles a lot better. You're going to put this right in the center of your feet. Make sure it's in the center of your feet. Don't have it too close to your toes because you don't want to snap back up. We don't want to have this happen. Now this is going to look a little awkward, so bear with me. You're going to come down, put it right over your shoulders, okay? Now, make sure it doesn't roll onto your neck. Now first, looking through the front, my legs are straight, I'm engaging my quads, I'm holding onto my band, I'm coming down straight. That's going all into my glutes, all into my hamstrings. It is so amazing. This is really top 10 exercise. It's fabulous. I'm going to awkwardly turn with this on. I'm going to show you a side view. Okay? Again, engaging through my glutes, pulling my shoulder blades back, coming down nice and straight, coming back up, squeezing, down, back up. One more time from the side. Coming back up. Okay? Now we're getting into the workout push, and this works so many muscles. I want you guys to do this right. I want you to really incorporate this. If you do have lower back problems, you'd probably want to skip this one, okay? We're going to do 10 right here. Now watch my legs. They stay straight. I don't bend into this at all. Really pushing the hips back. So it's almost like as you come back, you want your hips to slide back even further. Good, I'm gonna do 6 more. 5, squeezing my shoulder blades as they come up. 4, 3, 2, and 1. I'm gonna take a very quick break and we're gonna actually do another set so that you can watch it again and you can really look at how I hold the band so it doesn't roll forward onto my neck. You never wanna have that pressure that it's just too dangerous, it's not worth the risk. So we'll just do a quick set of 8. Keeping my legs straight, pushing my hips back. I'll turn sideways again so you guys can see it. My feet are hip width apart, coming down and back up. We'll do 5 more right here. Here's 4, nice and straight. 3, 2, and 1. Coming back up. Now, when you get out of this, 1 foot comes out first. And then you can either take an arm out or you can take your other leg out. Don't just step out of it because it's going to snap back up of you. So I want you guys to all write that down. It's called a banded good morning exercise. A beginner, 1 set of 15 reps. If you've never done anything like this before, you also would want to start with a little bit of a lighter band. Just get, usually the company I go through, the band, the red band is the thinnest. It's phenomenal. It's like $8. This is going to get you through 5 exercises just today. We're going to do this, okay? We're going to go into a shoulder and an upper back exercise now with this band. I get really excited about these because I love these, okay? So I'm stepping into this again. Another little trick too, the further out you step, the more tension you have. So if your beginner band gets a little too easy, just step a little bit wider. Okay, so we're going to do some upright rows. We did these last week with a dumbbell and a kettlebell, but today we're going to do it with a band. Pulling up here, coming down. The nice thing about a band is it offers you resistance going up and coming down, so you get a little bit more of a workout with it, and it doesn't take up any space. So if you travel a lot and you're in your hotel and you don't have, the gym's not that equipped, you don't have a lot of time, pack a couple bands with you and put all of these moves together and you'll be able to do a workout. Okay, now when I come up, I really retract. In any class I teach, I'm constantly yelling, tighten your body, retract your shoulder blades, make sure your rib cage is really tight. I'm gonna say the same thing to you guys. So we're just gonna do five more. Tucking my chin a little bit, here's four, three, two, squeezing, and one. Awesome. Now remember, if you guys ever have questions too, you can always email into the station and I can kind of guide you a little bit more on what to do, and my email will go up at the end. Okay, now we're gonna get some bicep curls in with this too. This is like, you can do, oh my gosh, like thousands of different things with this. Okay, curling up and coming down. I'm gonna show you from the side. Feet are nice and close together. You don't have to go too wide on this. Little bit of a bend to the knee. Shoulder blades are retracted. Squeezing up. Coming back down. Keeping all of that tension on my biceps the entire time. All right, let's get a nice set of 10 in. So when you do these, really focus on squeezing. Good. Retract those shoulder blades. And I lost count, so we'll go with five more. And here's four, retract, three, two, and one. Awesome job. Now, I want to go into what not to do. This is my, probably one of my top pet peeves for when I see women doing it in the gym. And it's not because you just think that it's an amazing exercise. Most women just don't know that this is an exercise they should not do. That can sometimes be the bad thing with social media. So this movement right here, with a weight in your hand, a plate in your hand, a kettlebell, a dumbbell, this move all the time, that is going to thicken your waist. It is going to make your waist wider. It is going to expand you. That is not what you want to do. A lot of people will think when they're doing this move that they're going to make their waist get that nice little hourglass effect to it. It's going to tighten you up. It's not. It's going to add mass to you. Get rid of it. Take it completely out of your program. I literally only use this move a couple weeks before my physique competitors get on stage to thicken up their obliques. That's the only time you ever want to have that in with you, okay? And squats, what not to do. You have this. You come down and you come up onto your toes, okay? So let's put this down. I'm doing this because I just really want you guys to make sure that you're getting really good workouts. When you come down, people will tend to raise their heels up. That takes away from all of the work that you're doing. You want to stay on your flat foot. Shoes are really key. I'm also going to kind of talk about that a little bit. Coming down, coming up. Again, this is what we don't do. We don't come down and lift the heel up. We stay flat-footed, okay? Now, I'm not saying go out and buy like the most expensive shoes. You don't need to. But you want to have a flat base for when you're squatting or deadlifting, or even just do it in your socks. I usually tend to wear Chucks. 20 bucks a pair, super easy, you get a great workout, you have a really good grip on the ground. That keeps your legs stable, tends to help with your balance too, okay? Now, here we go. I'm gonna grab my dumbbell. We're gonna do a combination move, okay? So I'm gonna come down into a squat, and then I'm just gonna lift up. That's it. We're leading into a bigger movement, but that's gonna come in a few weeks. So we're gonna just stick with this, so watch me again. Squatting down, I'm sinking, that weight's tapping the ground, I'm coming up. Super easy, okay? Flipping down, here, and up. Down, and up. And I promise you, within a couple weeks, we're gonna move into that bigger movement and you're gonna understand all these little pieces. Let's do four more this side. Here's four, squat down, drop that booty. Three, two, and one, come back down. Make sure you always go back down so that you don't only do like 7.5 reps because that's not cool. We wanna do the full reps. All right, same thing. Other side, set yourself up, take your time. Tapping down, squatting up, flipping. I'm landing at my shoulder. I'm not coming out at all. Back down. Notice too, my eyes travel with my weight. So I'm always looking at where my weight's going. Good, let's get four more. Wait till you see this all put together in a couple weeks. Three, two, and one. What do? We take that weight back down, okay? I'm gonna scoot that out of the way. So by building into bigger movements, you always wanna break them down and do the smaller movements. That way you don't get overwhelmed when you see someone picking up some super heavy weight and they're flinging it around. Number one, we don't fling weights around. We go slow and steady and consistent in small increases. That's what's gonna get you to your goals. I am gonna move down to the ground now, so you guys need to do the same thing. Okay? Get a drink of water really quick if you need it. If not, we're gonna move directly onto our glutes and we're gonna take a seat. And we're gonna bring this band back. Now, if you don't have a band with you right now, that's fine. You can do these movements with weights too. I'm just showing you different options. Take this, put this in the middle of your feet again. Notice it's not close to my toes. I'm gonna grab down a little bit lower on the band. I'm gonna make sure my mic's not in the way. And we're gonna work the back. Good mornings go fabulous with a back exercise. So we're gonna do what's called a seated row. This is you could do this on the gym, on a cable machine. We're not in the gym. This way we can do it at home and you can still get your workout in. Also, I'm pulling and I'm squeezing. That's it. I'm staying nice and tight. My back's staying up nice and straight. You guys keep doing with this. I'm gonna switch to the side so that you can see me a little bit better. So you notice I'm sitting up nice and straight. My shoulder blades are retracted. Pulling and releasing. Pulling and releasing. So we're working your rhomboids. That's the middle of your back. That's a great exercise. It's really important too, especially for women to work. I've been preaching that for years. We want to keep those spines nice and strong. We want to hit all of our stabilizing muscles. So we're going to do five more right here. Five, squeezing, my chin's tucked. Four, three, two, and one. And come down, make sure you finish the rep out. Okay, now we're gonna do a single arm row. We always have that side that's a little bit stronger than the other side, so we wanna make sure we work them both. So one hand's just gonna just gently, don't put a lot of tension on it. And then we're gonna pull single. Now notice when I pull, I come straight back. Here's what you don't wanna do. You don't wanna pull out here. We don't wanna hurt anything, okay? And we wanna work the muscle that we're supposed to be working. Tucking my chin just a little bit, my feet are together. Here we go, I'm gonna do five more on this side. Just five and four, good, squeezing. Three, two, and one. Come all the way back down, finish it. Changing your hand position on the other side, and we're gonna do this. And I'm really, when I pull back, I really retract my shoulders. Let's get five more. Here's five, four, three, two, and one. All right, now we're gonna step it up just a little bit. So all you need to do is you just need to come onto your knees. That's it, take your band off. Not a lot of position changing, okay? So with a band, again, if you don't have a lot of money to invest into a lot of different weights, you don't need to. Make this investment before you do anything. Get this and a mat. You'll be good to go. We're gonna work shoulders. I'm just gonna hold on to one part of it. You're gonna come up chest height, okay? And you're gonna pull out and you're gonna come back in. How simple is that? Really hits those rear deltoids, back of your shoulders. You're gonna get a little bit of tricep action in there too. Some core action, stay nice and tight. Squeezing and in. And we're gonna do 10 more. Don't forget to breathe. So when I pull back, I can feel this right in my shoulder blades. And if you can feel that, you know that you're making that connection into where you need to. Good, tucking my chin. This is a great exercise that will really change that definition on those upper bodies. Remember, tank top season. Here we go. Let's get 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now, you're just gonna kind of shake it out for a second because we're gonna pulse it out. We're gonna really just kind of do a little bit of a burnout set, and we're just gonna really fry the backs of those shoulders. Okay, now make sure when you're doing this, your arm, your wrist is stacked with your elbow is stacked with your shoulder. You don't wanna be hanging down below, okay? So we're gonna do is pulse. We're gonna squeeze. Your arms are gonna be on fire. That's okay, let them burn. Okay, if you obviously, if you feel any pain, you need to stop. But you need to learn the difference between a good pain and a oh pain. We don't wanna have a bad pain. Let's go with 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Release that down. Okay, I'm gonna go back onto my back and I'm gonna turn sideways so that you guys can see what I'm doing. Gonna scoot this stuff out of the way. Make sure you guys are staying hydrated too, especially it's getting a little bit nicer out. Gonna put this back on the center of my feet. And I'm going to lay down. And just move my mic just a little bit. Move this. All right, now watch. This is gonna be amazing. You can do this without a band. I am just going to lower my legs down halfway. I'm going to pull back up. So I'm getting a little bit of upper body action. My core is contracting. Down and up. Notice I'm not going all the way down. Move that. Good. And relax your face. Don't tighten up that neck. Here we go for 8, 7. Very slow movement. 6, tight, 5, and 4. I know it's painfully slow, that's okay. 3, 2, and 1. Now come back up. We're gonna bring the legs, we're gonna drop them down, and we're gonna push out. Now we're gonna keep hold of this band, so I'm looping my hands in it a little bit more. And I'm gonna push out, and I'm gonna come back in. I'm gonna push out, coming back in. We're adding resistance without the risk of thickening the waist. So this is something you could do a ton of reps with. But we're just gonna do 10 more just for now. You're gonna feel this all into the upper region of your core. Pushing out, notice my knees don't come all the way in. I keep them right stacked above my hips. Here we go, for 4, 3, squeezing, 2, and 1. And come back in. Now very easily take that off and come back up, okay? That was just a few exercises. Every week we're gonna do more and more exercises that you can combine into your notebook, and then as we go through, we'll kind of break that down so you have some really, really good workouts that you can follow through. Couple other things I wanted to talk about. I got some messages about what people really wanted to know about what kind of, you know, like a little quick pre-workout meal they could eat, a post-workout meal that they could eat that was quick and easy. So I brought a couple things. This is what I do. Keep in mind I am a vegan, so I do different protein powders than you guys may do, or some of you that are vegan may do the same ones. If you do, it's a fabulous one. I just keep my packets and I add it to coconut water. That way, my blood stays stable. I don't have any of that crash going on an hour later. I'm getting some protein into my body within probably, I probably do this within 10 minutes after my workout. As I'm driving, I have this ready to go, and it is amazing. Now, you could also just buy a big jar of it, and you could portion it and just put it into little plastic bags. I travel a lot, so this is a little safer to bring on the airplane with me, and they're really not that expensive. But vanilla protein, coconut water, it's like a dessert. It is amazing because you really want to make sure you're fueling your body and that you have energy before your workouts too. That's key. A lot of times when people are working out all the time and they're not getting the results that they want, it's because their nutrition is off. So getting that in line plus your workouts, it takes a little bit of time. Have some patience with it. Reach out to somebody that does if you need help. I am taking on clients. I can certainly help you out with that, and we can get everything in line for you. One other thing I want to cover today that seemed to be a really big question that people want to know about, a weight belt. So, for the workouts that we're doing right now, the weights aren't that heavy, so you really don't need a weight belt. But if you're lifting a heavier weight, you're doing heavy squats, deadlifts, you're doing really heavy back exercises, you want to have a weight belt. You want to protect yourself, okay? This is the one that I like for the movements that I do because it simply just goes on and then I can latch it. And then when I'm in between my sets, all I have to do is so I can breathe, okay? When you wear a weight belt, you need to have it in the center of your core. You don't want to have it too low because you're kind of defeating the purpose of it. Again, if that's something you're not sure of, write in. I will definitely guide you on different options, different price ranges, what you can do. I don't make any money off of this. This is just something I really think that people should protect their bodies with. Learning how to use a weight belt too is another totally different subject that we will talk about because I know that some of you are ready to progress. You've been watching this show for years and you're ready to take it to the next level and I want to take you guys there safely. So I hope that you really enjoyed today. Make sure you stretch, okay guys, and make sure you get some water and some food in you. I hope that you have a wonderful weekend and we will be back next week with yet more exercises that you can add to your repertoire and you can just have fun doing it. Have an amazing day. Thanks so much, guys.